Hey everybody, Chris Rowe, Rowe Hunting Resources here. All right, we are, I think this is what, part five on the series I'm doing about changing out your discs on the RTP Outdoors Genesis 3 no-till drill. All right, and so far we've prepped it, got it hoisted up, got the old ones off, put the new ones on, talked about the bearings and all that. So now at this point, they're on. All right, so I got these new discs on. And like I talked about in the last video, when these are getting put on, well, when they're getting taken off and putting on, okay, these get squeezed together, get compressed together, all right, so that way it puts those discs under tension. I'm going to get my finger off of the, I'm going to kill the video again. I've already tried to do this twice. All right, so it puts these under tension, all right. So the first disc that you put back on the post, on each arm, is gonna be very easy because it's gonna slide on, you're gonna tighten down that nut, and that disc is gonna go on because it's not under compression, it's not under any tension whatsoever. It's the second one that you put on that is going to press into the first one. So the first one goes on easy, the second one goes on a little bit more difficult, and you're gonna need the wrench throughout most of the threads, all right? So my recommendation, I think it just, I don't know, it's not that I think, it just, that's what I found for me being right-handed. Whichever side is most difficult for you to work on, do that side first. So in this case, I put the offside disc on first. Being right-handed, it was just easier. So now that left side, or my left, the machine's right side, this offside disc went on first, went very, very easy. Didn't have to hold much, okay? Didn't have to brace anything, really torque on anything, very difficult, okay? This side was the one that took a little extra effort, so now, being right-handed, this was a little easier. I could get this in there. Once I get the threads going, make sure they're not cross-threaded and they're gonna start to seat pretty quickly, then I can hold with my other arm, I can crank down on the ratchet on this side, so I can block stuff up, I can hold, I can torque. And it's just a little bit easier for me being right-handed to work on whatever right-hand side nut that I'm working on in this case. So that's what I did here. But, okay, and the reason why that's scraping is because I've got the spring inside. I've got some stuff that I prepped on this other side. But anyway, so here we are. We've got new discs, new bearings, and the rest of them. So I've just done two here. The rest of them are all the same. It doesn't matter if you're doing the Genesis 3. It doesn't matter if 5, 8. Doesn't matter how many you're doing there. I'll just like rinse and repeat. Rinse and repeat. Just do the same thing over and over and over again, okay? So at this point, what I'm at the stage of now, you see that obviously I'm sitting on my butt and I've lowered the machine down. Why? Okay, because once you get the discs installed, you've got to put it back together. And you got to put it back together. Oops, dang it. I didn't get myself prepped. Hold on, give me a second. I'm gonna have to lower this down so I've got my little extension arm. Again, I'm doing this by myself. I don't recommend that. Boom, we got it. I don't recommend working on it yourself, just not as handy, it's not as easy. But it is what it is. I'm stuck here doing it myself today. Other people had other responsibilities and I needed to get this done. So, obviously, the spring and the drop tube need to go back on, all right? And so here we go. So what it is this spring, here are the ones that have not been removed yet. You can see how they are. You know what they are because of the way they are. So there you go. So these chains are under tension right now. These are holding these arms up. The spring is under tension. It's compressed. There's your drop tube. So this tube right here, that's your drop tube. That's where the seed comes out of the seed tray, drops, it falls down through here. This spring goes over it, oops, like this. This tube's here, so the seed falls through here, falls through the spring, falls through this little cup here or sleeve here, just helps focus that seed as it falls down through and bounces along that spring. And then it goes into the hole down below. Goes through that hole there, falls down inside, falls into that slot that these discs open up in the soil, falls down into that little slot, and then as it rolls back over or rolls over it, the firming wheels go over top of it and close that whole thing up. All right, so this, let me get that in there. this spring needs to go back in here, right? Well, it's gonna take multiple hands in order to do it, all right? Ideally, you've got someone else here to help you. If you don't, you're gonna have to do one at a time. That's what I'm gonna have to do. Is so get it lower, so lower the machine down to where you've got enough play in here to where you can put this over this drop tube and set it in place. And so it sits there and it'll hold itself in place, okay? Now, here's what I've been doing. Here's what I did. I played with it a couple times to make sure it was working and it worked well. Up above here, in the bottom of, underneath the bottom of that tray, up in there. That is just a basic flat panel up in there. So there's nothing that you need to line up as far as the spring is concerned. Okay, it just centers itself around that drop tube. However, down here, you may be able to see, I don't know. Down in the bottom, there is actually a little race down there, a little indentation where the bottom of that spring needs to fit in. Well, obviously, it's at an angle, so the spring needs to be flexed as the machine is coming down, compressed. As you lower the machine, it's gonna lower this arm. It's gonna start to compress that arm. As that arm compresses, it's gonna start to compress that spring. Again, remember, this spring has got some serious tension to it. So as you drop that machine, it's gonna compress that arm. It's gonna compress that spring. So you need to hold the spring in place to make sure it pops down into that little cup, that little holder that it has down in there, so that it makes sure it stays lined up. Otherwise, that spring is gonna slide out to the left or right and it's gonna just gonna grind on your disc and it's not gonna work right, all right? So you really do need two hands doing it. So this is where I'm gonna go and get creative with this garbage can. See what I tell you, who needs all these fancy, there we go, who needs all these fancy iPhone holders? Right, I've got one. It's called a Rubbermaid garbage can handle. All right, it's a little cockeyed, but you get the gist. All right, so remember, keep a 2x4 handy like we had in the beginning. So here we go. I'm gonna lower it down. I've got all four legs, just like I'm just gonna lower it down like I normally do and let it sit on these four legs, just like it's under a standard storage type scenario, okay? But what I'm going to do as this is lowering down, now again, if you're working with several other people, all right, you know, maybe there's one person holding these two, another person. I just think it's probably gonna be better to just do it one at a time. Yes, you're going up and down, but it's just a lot easier in my opinion anyway. But be able, this is my little extension arm here for my down pull. All right, so I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna push the spring all the way up to the top, all right? I'm gonna hold it there, and then I'm gonna start to lower this down. Now this, on the three, this is the crappery right here, because this bar is gonna be coming down low. So. All right, as that machine starts coming down, I'm keeping my, and again, wear gloves, all right? My hand is in contact with this disc right now, and that I'm telling you, if you do not have an appreciation for it unless you've played with these things, these discs are extremely sharp. And if you don't have gloves, just make sure you got a suture kit or some super glue, because you're gonna need them. Because you're gonna be banging around under here and pushing stuff around, and I already, a couple times, you know, moving the spring around, drop it, bam, and my hand hits that edge of the disc. If you don't have gloves on, it will lay you wide open, all right? Just, you can either trust me on that, or you can learn the hard way. But either way, be careful of those discs, okay? So now I'm holding the spring up, and I'm pushing it in place, or pushing it over. Boom. All right, it's in the pocket. It is in the pocket. I'm gonna hold on. Flexing it over, holding it in the pocket. Bam. Okay, she's flexed, she's not going anywhere. Now that spring is under load. That spring is under load and it is in the little pocket that it's supposed to be in there, okay? So as that thing is coming down, that arm is starting to compress this spring. All I'm doing is putting a little pressure on that spring this way to make sure that in that little cup, that spring doesn't just sit on the outside of that cup. That spring comes down in the middle of that cup, which is over here, and then as it compresses, it stays in the middle of that cup. Does that make sense? All right, so you gotta put a little bit of torque over on that spring, pushing it forward so it engages and it compresses and stays inside that cup, all right? So I'm gonna make sure my chain is out of the way, which it should be. There we go. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and set it all the way down. Boom, there we go. So the machine now is just sitting just exactly like the machine would sit in a normal storage scenario, all right? All right, so that brings us to this, okay? Now, in the first video I already said, these pieces right here, okay? These pieces right here that hold that chain in place, okay? These are under tension, again, these chains are under tension and that spring, each of those springs is compressed, okay? That's why you can see they end up getting bent, all right? Each of these pins ends up getting, and this one's just seriously bent, all right? So they're kind of a one-time deal. If you're gonna replace all these, you've gotta take them off, and once you take them off, they end up getting stripped and popped out, and so you gotta replace them. I did not know that going into this. I wasn't even thinking about that. So tomorrow I've got to run to the hardware store and pick a couple of these, or the Farm and Ranch store, and I've got to pick a few of these up. So I'm not going to be able at this moment to be able to lock them in place perfectly. But the gist is exactly this, all right? So you need to be able to get your chains back attached to the body, right? Well, just like we did before, okay? That's where the 2x4 comes in, all right? So, just like we did before. Grab that arm, and she's stout, okay? That's why I say block it up with a 2x4. Pick that baby up, oh jeez. Pick that baby up. Put the 2x4 underneath it. Now it is compressed the spring a little bit more to where it gives you slack in that chain, which means when you get the new one of these, okay, that post, you can bring this up in there, put the post in there, screw her down, and away you go. Screw it down, get it attached. Landowner's here. Perfect timing now that I'm done. Anyway, get it in there, screw it down, get her attached, and you're done. And then again, rinse and repeat. Raise it back up, get it to where you can slide this over the post, get it in place, hold it in place, lower it back down, make sure you flex that spring into the cup, bring it all the way back down so it's in place, grab it, block the tire up, and repeat. So that's how you do that. And after that, that's how you replace the discs on your Genesis 3.